We're here at CBS 2016 in Nairobi, Kenya, and I'm very pleased to be joined by Cornelius Wafula, who is lead developer for Easyprep. Cornelius, thank you very much indeed for being with us today.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me.
Now, you're here representing Easyprep. It's been selected here as one of a number of young innovators, innovating projects here that have technological solutions for socio-economic development. I wanted to ask you about Easyprep and your project. Perhaps you can give us a little bit of a pitch on that.
Well, first of all, I appreciate being invited to showcase our product to this event. Yeah, for us, we have a product called Easyprep. Easyprep is more like a virtual education platform where students get to interact with the content virtually rather than having the hard copies, the books, and all that. Yeah, so the platform is internet-based at the moment. Yeah, so the users will require maybe a device, computer, laptop, tablet, mobile phone to access the content. Yeah, and the good thing about Easyprep is that the content is structured specifically for the student's needs. Yeah, so if a student is taking a specific curriculum and he's at a certain stage of his education, the content delivered to him by default is based on that, based on the curriculum they're taking, the level of education they are at the moment, by default. So unless he wants to look for other more content from different areas and other curriculums, he can conduct a search in the platform and get the content delivered to him.
And is it early days for you at the moment, or are you quite far in your development process?
Yeah, the development process is, I can say, roughly 90% complete. We're looking forward to having a soft launch early next year in January. Yeah, so that we can get some users on board, actual users, who will probably interact with the system, give us a few feedbacks here and there, and probably can polish up on areas that might need some improvement. But at the moment, it's currently under test. Yeah, we have testers, some in Ghana, some here in Kenya, and we're in the process of uploading some content during the test process as the testers interact with it. We are getting some positive feedback on which we are improving on it. Yeah.
Great. And what is your USP?
Yeah, okay. I can say innovators around the education platform, there have been quite many from way back. But our selling point mostly is how the content is structured for the user. Yeah, because most of these other platforms, they just bombard the user with the content. So, and students being students, the larger the quantity, the lower the motivation. Yeah, so we're just trying to deliver the content in small bits in areas where the student needs, like on the platform, a user maybe wants to access content for science. He can maybe search for the subject science, which specific topic he wants to access, and the content will be delivered in subtopic forms. So if he's not interested in this subtopic, he can jump onto the next subtopic and interact with it, go through the content. Yeah, so there are also other key features that are selling point, because we also have sample questions, test questions from the lesson content that the student has been reading through. We have timed tests. These are intended to improve the student timing ability because it mimics a real exam. Because in a real exam, if it's 2 hours, it's 2 hours. When 2 hours are over, the teacher is coming picking up the papers. So with time tests on the platform, the student can do it a number of times and test his ability to be punctual with the taking of the test.
Great.
We also have tokens during the test-taking process. If a student successfully gets a question right, he's awarded tokens, and these tokens are useful because on the platform we have also games for entertainment purposes, because all work and no play makes Jack dull boy. And these tokens are used to unlock the games for the student. So this encourages the student to be excellent in the tests. Yeah, we also have social features, study groups. Students can create study groups virtually with other students and maybe have a discussion online. Yeah, share content with others. Yeah, so it's not specifically wired to academics. It's more like a whole school system transferred to in a virtual world.
Well, it sounds very complete, and the road to success is never an easy one, but we wish EasyPrep the very best of luck, and thanks very much for being with us in the studio today.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me as well. Yeah, we're looking forward to getting more users on board and probably launch it in also schools, so that the schools will also get their students to take up the product and use it more frequently.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you too.
We'll